In lesson 1.5, students see a deflated basketball on a balance or scale, and then the teacher inflates the basketball and they see that it has more mass. So kids learn that a gas is matter. It takes up space and it has mass. And since they already know that matter is made up of particles, the conclusion is that a gas is also made up of particles. So the question is, how does heating and cooling affect a gas? Well, kids learn that the particles of a gas are far apart, that they're not very attracted to each other, that when they're heated, they move faster, and when they're cooled, they move more slowly. Let's take a look. Here's a molecular animation, and kids have already seen that in a solid, the particles are very attracted to each other, that they just vibrate in fixed positions. And in a liquid, the particles are also attracted to each other, so they're pretty close together, not quite as attracted to each other as they are in a solid, so they're able to move past each other. And in a gas, kids are introduced to this idea that it's very different than in a solid and a liquid. There's almost no attraction between the particles, so they just hit each other and bounce off. Now, in an activity, kids see the effect of heating and cooling on a gas. Let's take a look. They take a little empty bottle and dip it in a detergent solution, and then place the bottom of the bottle in hot water. And a bubble forms on the top of the bottle. And then they take that same bottle and put it in cold water, and the bubble shrinks. And the question is, why does this happen? If we think about gas as made up of particles, why does this phenomena occur? So we have another animation, or actually kids can suggest that the heating of the gas made the particles move faster and blew up the bubble, and cooling the gas made the particles move more slowly and caused the bubble to come down. And that's exactly right, and this animation puts a little more detail on it. Here, this bottle has already been placed in bubble solution. Those red arrows were the outside air pressure. Here, it's being placed in hot water, and the particles move faster and push against the outside air pressure and cause a bubble. Here, when placed in cold water, the particles slow down and they don't push as hard against the outside air pressure, so the outside air pressure makes the bubble get smaller. And kids use the activity sheet to make their own drawings and to write captions and explain this. There's a teacher background information that includes a little extra information on this. The particles and gas have almost no attraction for each other. So when they're heated up, you don't have to overcome attractions of gas particles. They just move faster and hit the bubble film harder and move it up against the outside air pressure. And when you cool a gas, they move more slowly, but their attractions are so minimal that it's not the attractions that are bringing them together. It's just that they move more slowly, they have less pressure in the bottle, and the outside air pressure pushes the bubble in. Now, if you're in an NGSS state, we have this performance expectation that we've looked at throughout Chapter 1, and that's develop a model that predicts and describes changes in particle motion, temperature, and state of a pure substance when thermal energy is added or removed. Now, again, we're not at the changing state phase yet, but we are getting the entire picture of solids, liquids, and gases, that they're all made of particles, that if you heat them, they move faster, and if you cool them, they move more slowly. And as that is background, understanding what happens during phase changes in Chapter 2 will be much easier. And if we look at the individual dimensions of the performance expectation, you can see that Lesson 1.5, kids are developing a model to describe a phenomena. The phenomena in this case is the bubble growing on the bottle and shrinking when it's put in hot and cold water. They're learning that gases are also made up of particles, just like they learned about liquids and solids. And as far as cause and effect goes, if the effect is the bubble increasing in size, the cause is the heating of the particles and making them move faster. And if the effect is the shrinking of the bubble, the cause is cooling the gas and making the particles move more slowly. So, thanks for watching, and good luck with the lesson.